Hey folks, Kevin with the A-Home Design. Thank you for watching this video. If you're watching it, hopefully you're watching it that you see me there. Today we are going to talk about hardwood floors, which is very popular, is the most common used floors in all of our new remodeling and projects. And I want to explain a little bit about hardwood floors and educate you about it. Hardwood, it's of course a natural product, and there are different species of wood which they are going to look different. Some people do researches about hardness of them. They are looking for harder wood and all that, but the hardwood, you don't research or don't go look for the best one. There is no best one because it's natural material. You gotta look for the look that goes with your decor and the design and of your house. What we are going to hear explain about some of the different types of it. Of course, you can get, for sure you're familiar, you can get hardwood like oak, maple, hickory, birch, and cherry. But most commonly used one in the industry is oak and maple, which is, this is maple. As you see, it has a little bit more uniform look. And you have oak, which is a little bit of a more character, busier look, a little bit more traditional and classic look. In two different ways they cut the wood, or they make it to put it, assemble it together. One is called the solid wood, which is basically cut, a solid one piece wood cut from a piece of lumber. And this type can be only installed and used on subflooring. That's above grade. You should have a subflooring like plywood. Older homes, sometimes builders use particle board, but this has to be nailed down. It's solid. You cannot glue this down. You cannot put this on concrete. You cannot use it on condos that they have a concrete floor, or gypsum. There's a new product. They use it instead of concrete because it is very sensitive to moisture, excessive moisture coming up from concrete. You get a thick wood here, but most people don't realize that you can, this is, not all of this is actually usable to you. The wood has tongue and groove. They create this groove and a tongue on the other side that they lock to each other, and the tongue is guiding these boards to sit tight together. For sand and finishing in the future, resurfacing, refacing it, you can only use this thickness on the top. From this point down, it is doing nothing. You cannot go beyond this, you cannot go lower. That's why it doesn't matter how thick it is. Nowadays, more common wood that's being used is called engineered wood, which is this product on the top, if you see it. Cross-cut of this. This is a cross-cut of this. This is the solid wood and a matching one engineered on the top. But sometimes people think this is not real wood. They think it's engineered, but it's not. It is real wood. There is a top veneer which is cut from the same one and attached to some other boards that's put together underneath. They call it engineered because this is normally being done in two different plants, and they bring it and then assemble it, press it together. The advantages of engineered wood is that it's dimensionally is more stable, it doesn't react to humidity and moisture. You can install it on any grade, below, on, or above grade. It can be glued to concrete, it can be floated, it can be nailed down, stapled down, and you can use it in any space, any area. You can go with engineered wood with wider planks if you like to have wide plank wood. You cannot do that with solid, it is risky. If anybody has more than 4 to 5 inch, they could absorb the moisture and expand a lot in summer. And when we have dry winters, it could shrink, and all of these movements is gonna create big gaps between the wood, with solid wood. But if you go with engineered, you won't have that problem. It's not waterproof, just don't get me wrong. This is very moisture and humidity resistant. You gotta be careful with all of these terms. But how they do it, they use all these boards. This could be engineered boards or even pine sometimes. They take these layers and they put it together perpendicular to each other, because wood has a grain, has a direction. When they expand, when they're exposed to humidity, they expand. They expand on both two different directions. That's why they offset each other. And it doesn't affect the top veneer, which is the real wood. But engineered comes in different qualities. The thicker the veneer is, you can sand and refinish it, reface it, exactly like a solid wood. If you go with, you know, more economical, cost-wise, as far as with engineered, the top veneer is very thin, and you might not be able to reface it. It might be a one-time use, then you have to replace the floor, of course. But engineered wood is becoming much more common, even on sub people above grade with subfloor like plywood and all that. People are doing engineered wood because you won't have any problem of the copying or the crowning, they call it. You don't need to constantly monitor the humidity and the temperature of in your house. I mean, it could happen you leave the windows or doors open. With solid wood, you gotta be careful, especially if you're going with the wider one. Wood look is great. I mean, everybody is going for wood right now in main, especially on main floors, and even in basements. But if you have a very active family, maybe wood is still not good for a basement. And water issue, water could always be an issue in a basement. The another product that looks like this now is very popular in the market. It's this product, which looks like wood. It comes in a different looks, brands, thicknesses, and performances. This is actually waterproof because it's not real wood. This is a vinyl floor. They call it LVP or luxury vinyl plank. They look pretty good. They're waterproof. They're only this thin. You cannot reface it. This is, you see, it is what you get. And but it lasts a long time. It won't fade. It won't stain. It is very resistant to traffic. To indentations because it's a kind of solid core. You can do this even on your main floor if you have a very active family lifestyle. And it's easy to maintain. You can literally wash it, but you cannot do that with hardwood. The one question always people ask, how to clean my wood? Hardwood is only a damp mop. You should not, you know, your mop should not be dripping on the floor. It should be a damp mop to protect your hardwood floor. And hardwood has a finish on the surface, but on the sides, they're not finished. They don't apply the finish on the sides. And from the seams, water can go in and start getting into the wood and damage it. Again, this is called LVP. These two are hardwood and LVP are the two most popular flooring items right now. And I can talk a lot about this and there's a lot more information, but you can ask us questions, you can send us comments, questions, anything, and we'll be more than happy to help you with all the information about the flooring. Okay, I hope this video helped you and the information was helpful to you for choosing your next flooring, but we'll be here to help you. Thank you for watching. Everybody have a good day.